So you told me your friend has bought an iPhone, but you would prefer a Pixel. Why?
I think it has to do something with my requirements for mobile device. What I specifically want to avoid is to have like a fanboy conversation now.
Okay.
Because I absolutely see the value of an iPhone.
Yeah.
I just don't see it in my life.
Okay.
Because an Android device, especially a newer Android device, is like a little computer in my pocket. I can even like put a terminal emulator on there, have like screen sharing on there. I can do anything because it's like a Linux distribution kind of thing.
Okay, so it's much more customizable. It's developer friendly.
Yeah. It's developer friendliness, I think is the word, because it's
or hacker friendly, where you can.
I don't really hack or customize anything, but the way it arrives when you get it, it's just that you can do like anything you want with it.
Yeah.
In a way, because the apps also don't get reviewed that heavily.
Okay.
Which
can be a good or bad thing.
It can be a good or bad thing, yes. But there are definitely apps that only exist for Android because it's only possible.
Right.
With Android, because Apple has private APIs for that stuff or anything like that.
Yeah.
But the flip side is that iOS is way more polished and
yeah.
It doesn't have the fragmentation problem. And it's
For me, I think like iOS. I mean, I like iOS. It's very good. It's very simple. But it always frustrates me. Like if I want to customize something, like, I can't. Like it's very limited.
That's true, yes. Yeah, it's limited, but in a good way.
In a good way,
say,
of course.
Yeah.
Like for me, if I want to buy a phone from my parents, I would buy them an Apple phone because...
Yeah, exactly. You don't have any like trouble setting it up.
And you can't screw it up. There's no way to screw up in iOS. Like settings, it's all very... It's standardized. Yeah, everything's the same.
Actually, own an iPad.
Okay.
Because of this very reason. It's just the thing that you kick back on the couch, you open the iPad.
It serves the exact purpose, so you don't have to mess.
I can just like watch movies with it or stuff like that, but that's it.
Yeah.
And the thing that it's always in my pocket, I want it to be very versatile.
Yeah. Makes sense. Okay. So he's an Android fanboy.
Yeah.
Nah. It serves its purpose. It depends on what you need. Like if you want to do something, if an iOS doesn't do it, then why buy an iOS device? Although, what about Windows versus Mac?
Oh.
Or like, you know?
It's actually kind of the same question, but the other way around.
Yeah.
That I grew up with a MacBook, actually.
Oh.
Yeah, I ended up using it, and this is actually not a bad thing because when I got into software development, I could just use it as a development device. And nowadays, I don't have any choice because I'm an iOS developer, and only iOS can only be developed on Mac.
Have you done any development on Windows?
No.
Okay, interesting.
I fear to try it.
So I switched from a Windows to Mac because when I got my remote job at Zapier, they wanted me to have a Mac because all the stack, all the development like workflows are all like they rooted for Mac. So it was difficult to switch actually for about a few weeks, but then I find it's much more efficient to develop stuff on a Mac, I think.
Yeah, given that it's like it has a Unix kernel.
Yeah.
And you can use like similar environments without much virtualization.
Yeah.
And also, I think if I was employed as a software developer, I would use Linux.
Yeah.
For the simple reason, because it's even more efficient than Mac. But being like self-employed, I have to use Photoshop a lot. I have to use a lot of proprietary software a lot. And that's why I settled like in between on a Mac.
Right. Okay. Yeah.